Hi again, everyone, and welcome back to Glenlivet Estate, episode 3. Today we will be finishing off the harvest and then moving on to cultivating. So let's crack on and get the field harvest. I just want to thank you very much for everyone who has viewed the series so far and give it the thumbs up. It's really much appreciated, and also new subs as well. It's I really, really appreciate. So let's crack on, get this field harvest. I'll just do it manually, because there's not that much to harvest. Just a couple of bits. And what we'll do is we'll go and sell the rest of the grain, and we'll start cultivating. I had a wee bit of dilemma when I was harvesting off screen. And that was the size of the cultivator I bought. In the garage it says something about the horsepower required for the cultivator, and the equipment I've got, or the tractors I've got, are not powerful enough. But I have tested the dutes on the cultivator and it works well, so I'm glad about that. I don't have to go and buy or hire a bigger tractor, because as I said in the last video, I want to buy a bigger sealer. So if we have time at the end of the video, we'll go and sell the old seeder and we'll buy a new one ready for sowing the two fields. So that's that done. Just stop it, pipe out. Start this. Oh, I have purchased a new item off screen, and that was a power washer. It's one thing that we really need. As you can see, I can't even see out the window. So once we sell this, what's in the combine, we'll give the tractor a quick wash, then we'll hook up to the cultivator. Now, I've been around the farms since 2011. I've also been around farms in real life, although I haven't worked on them. My dad worked on the farm for a lot of years. My brother, he worked on the farm. He still does. He works for a crop spraying company. If anybody wants to know what my favourite tractor, type of tractor is a Massey Ferguson. Now, there is a wee bit of a story behind that. My grandfather worked for a Massey Ferguson dealership, which is local to me, but I was no longer there. And during the times we were up there, my grandfather let us sit in and play about with the new tractors, and that's why I really love Massey Ferguson. Another thing I've seen yesterday was the farmer dispute over the price of milk. The farmers are protesting on how much they get paid from the supermarkets for processing their milk. And what they're doing is they're going into supermarkets and they're actually clearing the shelves out of milk. And there was an actual video on YouTube. If I remember, I'll put the link for the video in the this video's description about the farmers going in the supermarket and absolutely clearing the shelves out of milk and walking out the store with them. Now, one of the supermarkets did get the police involved, but the police couldn't do anything about it as it was a peaceful protest. I'm actually with the farmers on this one. Because when you go buy milk from a supermarket, take Asda's or Morrisons for instance, the profit they make on milk is unbelievable. And it's just not milk that's happening. Anything you buy out of supermarkets, probably about 30% of the value of that item goes to profit for the supermarkets. And the farmers are, they're the ones that work hard, breeding their cows, milking the cows twice, I think it's twice a day that they milk them, and they're not getting very much money for it. So I could understand where the farmers are coming from. So we'll go and sell this, then we'll take the trailer back and we'll give the tractor a quick wash as I bought a pro puller washer, and we will start cultivating. So there we go. Here's our sell point. Made 3,000 off of that one. That's not too bad. So we'll take this back and pick up our cultivator. We'll start cultivating field number 5, I think it is. Small field. By the time I've cultivated that, I think that'll be the end of the episode. Just I think what's coming up in the next couple of episodes, we'll be buying new seeder obviously. And once the fields are sown, we'll fertilise them. And if I've got money left in the bank, what I want to do is start the sheep. I do have a small mower mod that I downloaded yesterday. If you remember the small mower off FS13, the small little red one, Ride-On, that's one I bought. So it'll be ideal to use it for more sheep. Then after that, I don't have an idea what I'm going to do. I would like to purchase more fuels from the sale of the oilseed rape that I'm going to sow in the two fields that we've harvested. Then hopefully we could might think about either another field or starting to do cows. Ideally, I'd like to buy another field because I don't think I would get many bales out the the fields I've got. So that's the tractor washed, and we'll just go and stick the trailer in one of the sheds. And we'll hook up our pull there. I know I've left the combine in on the in the field, but I'll get that off screen. As I say, I'm trying to keep the videos down to 20 minutes, and it'll just take too long for me to get the combine back in the yard. So I'll probably do that off screen before I cultivate that field. What's wrong with that? Line up properly. There we go. So we're going to cultivate number 5. So what's coming next on my YouTube channel? Well, I'll be continuing with this series. I don't really know what I'm going to do. I might do a few mod spotlights. There is a lot of good mods that seems to be coming out at the moment. Seen a couple of combines that look good. Also, some good maps. Unfold it. So yeah, I might start doing sort of mod showcases on maps or tractors or any equipment to do with farms. If there's any mods that you've seen which are reasonable, please put them in the description and a comment on the video, and I shall give the mods a look, and if I feel they're any good, I'll do a video on them. I'll just cultivate some of this, and I'll do the rest on off screen. Like I say, my videos go up on YouTube unedited. I do have an editing software. I think it's Windows Movie Maker I use. I just downloaded it the other day, and I haven't really had time to have a play about with it. So if anybody who uses Windows Media Player and can give me some tips, then please do. I'm always open for suggestions, as you know. And it would come in handy. So yeah. Like I say, there is a lot of good maps out at the moment. Chris7710 even in a partnership with I think it was WBF. His YouTube name is, and they've made a really good map. But as I said, maybe in my first video, I tend to play smaller maps like this. Because I don't play multiplayer games. I used to, but then you get people coming in, mucking about, and plowing your yard was one of things people done. I just don't have time for that sort of thing. I'd rather play my own game, and if I make the mess, then it's me that makes it. It's just the way I am. Even Euro Truck multiplayer, Euro Truck's another game I play quite a lot, and I think bringing out the multiplayer was the worst thing they ever done. Again, people dropping the roads in the middle of the motorway, bashing into you, causing you a lot of damage on your truck. But if that's the way people want to behave, then that's basically them. I just don't have time for people like that. Never have done. I mean, don't get us wrong, my dad plays, believe it or not, he plays Farm Simulator. It's actually me who got him in that. I had 2011, and I was going to give the game to my nephew, so I took it up to my dad's, and dad says, I said, Dad, can you give that to my nephew? And my dad says, yeah, I'll give it to him. So one of the times I was up, my dad says, that's not a bad game, that deal. I said, what game? He said, Farm Simulator 2011. And I said, well, have you been playing it? Yeah, I've been playing it. I says, I thought you were going to give it to my nephew. Oh, he says that I wouldn't run on his computer. So, your nephew installed it for me on my computer. So that was that. Then my dad got Farm Simulator 2013, and now he's got 2015. So yeah, so my dad plays a game, believe it or not, and my dad's nearly 70 year old. So the game's for all ages. Okay, so that's it for this episode, boys and girls. Hope you enjoyed the episode. If you like it, give it a thumbs up. Please feel free to share my channel as well. If you want your channel shared, I'm quite happy to do so. So until next time, bye for now.